Young Tasmanian drivers are significantly overrepresented in terms of death and serious injury on our roads.
I think young drivers have a sense of invincibility.
L-platers are the safest they'll ever be behind the wheel, but when they get their P-plates, their chance of death and serious injury skyrockets.
To be assessed as satisfactory, you need to show me you're driving to the standard that's set down by the Registrar of Licensing.
There's a whole range of different competencies that a learner driver needs before they can become independent. The time that they're driving with a supervisor is so much more than when I got my licence, which was, in hindsight, was really quite simple. Yeah. As a supervising driver, it's really important for us to stand back and let them make some mistakes, because we all make mistakes. We need to be able to learn from those mistakes and build our own behaviours.
The supervisor's job is to make sure those mistakes won't happen when the driver is licensed and the supervisor is no longer in the car.
You've passed your test, so it's an excellent result.
Thank you.
Good on you, Pat.
Thanks, mate. Getting your licence brings a lot of freedom and independence, so I'm keen for that. Where do you think the first place you'll go when you get your P's is, Ethan? There's a range of reasons young people are overrepresented in car crashes. So the obvious one is that we have a period where they're supervised and all of a sudden they don't have that supervisor or the security blanket. And then there's obviously a range of other issues that come into play around peer pressure, around perhaps not having the experience driving in a range of different conditions.
You definitely feel a sense of peer pressure when there's other people in the car.
So there's a lot we can do as supervising drivers. So the capacity for a learner driver to make decisions requires a lot of development.
Learning to drive is the same as learning any skill. The more supervised experience you have, the better you become.